We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we are looking at Hellchild, Blood Money, Issue 1 from Zenescope 2019. This is a four-part miniseries and it features Angelica Blackstone, aka Hellchild. And according to the little blurb on the inside cover, she's the half-vampire daughter of the Greek god Hades and currently a gun for hire. You're not really told most of that through the entire book. You just have to read the little paragraph at the beginning. Story by Joe Brusha, Ralph Tedesco, and Dave Franchini. Writer was Ralph Tedesco. Artwork by Butch Mapa. Colors by Dijjo. Letters by Taylor Esposito of Ghost Glyph Studios. Editor Terry Cavanaugh. Art direction and design Christopher Coate. Okay, so we start off with some hookers and rich kids hanging out together, and one of the hoes ODs and things go south from there. Fairly straightforward premise. Rich kid calls daddy to clean it up, and of course that's going to get uncovered fairly quickly because the girls work for this thug Tor, who apparently is mysteriously powerful within the underworld or something. So of course he is going to hire Hellchild to be her son's bodyguard. Now Hellchild, in case you didn't know, has the obvious mental illness haircut with the long dyed hair and shaved side. A couple of the kids that are involved in this get caught and their lives don't go very well. And, of course, the other bodyguards don't respect Hellchild because she's a woman, and things go wrong for the parents of the kid. Then, things start to go bad for Hellchild and her new ward, and suddenly she pulls out this little dagger that becomes this giant sword thing. Looks like one of those Klingon batleths. It just magically grows somehow. I don't know. This really didn't make a whole lot of sense because I have no idea who this character is, and there's very little sense of what her abilities are other than she's got red eyes. Beyond that, it didn't go into any detail. If you didn't read the little paragraph at the beginning, you'd have no idea that she's even a vampire. You'd just think she's some weird goth chick. Overall, it's a pretty mediocre book, kind of forgettable. It's a very generic plot line, which would be fine. It's not the worst written thing I've ever read, but there's definitely a lot of inserts here that are kind of annoying to me. First being the hairdo. It makes her look like every other character that's been created in the last 5 years. It's overly generic at this point. It's not edgy anymore, and it doesn't look cool. It just looks like she wants to talk to my manager and try and get me in trouble because I said some word that she didn't like. The cover is awesome. I love the cover art, but it does not match the interior art, which is far more inferior. It's okay, it's functional, but it's not great. For an indie book, it's okay. I expected a little better from Zenescope, but some of the scenes look pretty solid. Others look very forced. The images look very traced, very stock image looking, and very generic, and some of the color choices were a little odd, I thought, for like the carpeting and walls, and the backgrounds lack a lot of detailing, but overall, the art is passable and shows some promise. I was really disappointed. It's not worth $4. So this is definitely going to be a pass for me. If I knew more about the character, maybe it would be more interesting, but I've got nothing to work with here. I've never heard of this character before. I thought the cover looked cool, so I picked it up. And I regret that, because if I knew more about the character, like they gave me more than a one paragraph thing to work with, which it came off a little trite on the paragraph, but if they had introduced her a little better in here, then I probably would have liked this better. Otherwise, it's just generic hero woman, and it feels very social justice-y because of the stupid haircut and some of the like overtly misogynist things that the one bodyguard says to her. Otherwise, it was just kind of a forgettable, mediocre issue. If you find it cheap, pick it up, but I won't pay cover price for it. Might be worth $1, but if I saw it in the 50-cent box, I'd probably pick it up and not feel bad about it. But that's just my opinion. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. And we hope to see you on the next one.